out-of-jail murderer who first went behind bars as a teenager. Bronson Blessington was declared an animal, never to be released for his role in the 1988 abduction, rape and murder of 20-year-old Janine Balding in Sydney. He was 14 when he committed the crime, and after 28 years in prison, his deep remorse and rehabilitation are apparently clear to his supporters. So should he still be behind bars for a crime he committed so young? It's our daily dilemma this morning, and here to discuss this, please welcome John Caldwell. John, this is a really tough topic. Do you think at the age
definitely
of...
Definitely not bedtime reading, I'll say that, if you think you're going to go to sleep. The answer immediately when I read this was, yes, he deserves to be behind bars for it. But then when you unpack this a little more, there's more questions than answers. So, firstly, why was it such a media trial when he was 14, which doesn't happen? Then also, they then introduced retrospective laws, three different laws that have keep him in jail for the 175 years, which doesn't normally happen. So I'm a bit confused as to why this case is such a special case when other minor charges for minors are not treated like this, and they're not played out in the media, and the penalties are way less harsh.
It was such a horrific crime, though.
It was, but then, I mean, we've got a... There's an 18-year-old mother in Victoria last year who murdered her own baby, put it in a bag and left it under a tree, and is not going to serve 1 minute of prison time. So, I mean, and I think, where's that line of what is horrific and what is brutal? Do we go to where the US go, where a lot of states in the US don't have any minimum? So children as young as 8 can be tried as adults. I mean,
it's when you read his case that you start to wonder. You know, he was unwanted by his parents. His parents split when he was 6. They didn't want, in the long term, neither of them wanted him. The mother kept asking the police to take him away because he was a bit unruly. He was illiterate. He didn't go to school. He was put away into a home, then in detention and so on, and he eventually got bad company, as you would expect he might. Young boys, again, young, illiterate, not particularly bright, any of them, and then they did this terrible crime. Now he's been behind bars all this time, and you read it all and you think, yes, your immediate reaction is, yes, you should stay there. And then you start to think, well, gosh, I don't know. If you're rehabilitated, it won't bring Janine Baldwin back. That's the terrible agony of it all, isn't it? You cannot bring back the person he killed.
Also, her family, though, are very keen for him to remain behind bars.
Of course,
and wouldn't you be? It's important to respect the wishes of the family. I would not want to... Regardless of what he says he's done, all of that sort of, he should be remaining behind bars.
I guess the other question is,
his
lawyer didn't argue diminished capacity, which any other 14-year-old's lawyer would absolutely argue that. Right. And he would have been off in 10 years. I'm not saying that's the right thing, but I think, for me, I hate what he's done, but I just, the system, I don't think, has really protected him very well. I did read a lot of what he was saying about his upbringing, and, you know, anyone who knows anything about my upbringing was very, very similar. And I just don't think that's a very good excuse. No, I'm sorry. No. Like, you make choices. Yeah, it doesn't matter. And he was sexually abused and. That doesn't explain what he did.
Well, it certainly doesn't excuse it.
John, thank you. And let's look at some feedback on this hot topic this morning. Firstly, to Sarah, just because he is remorseful doesn't mean he deserves to get out and live a normal life. That poor woman can't do that. And this from Tango, psychopaths are cunning and can learn to act with empathy. Psychopaths cannot be rehabilitated.
That's true.
And finally from Corinne, why change his sentence? Janine can't change hers. John, thanks again for joining us.